When I go to Assisi with pilgrims each year, I reconnect with the life of St. Clare of Assisi. St. Clare was a woman of her time, of the Middle Ages, the 13th century, but who grew up with a mother and sisters who were cultivating a separate gospel vocation within their medieval reality for women, and also kind of pushing the envelope, part of a movement, really, of medieval women who were kind of branching out of the traditional religious roles. Clare's vocation as a gospel woman was nurtured in her home, kind of on a parallel track with St. Francis. And then when she encountered Francis and heard about him, of course, in the small confines of a little town like Assisi, you couldn't help but hear about Francis. They had mutual spiritual interests. And then I think they became acquaintances, friends, soulmates, perhaps, in the spirit. And yet throughout her life, and even that she survived Francis by many years, she was a woman of great independence, who knew what she wanted for the shape of her gospel life with her sisters, and stuck with that even when the officials in the church, the Holy Father, cardinals, wanted to kind of contain or put boundaries around her lifestyle. She knew what she wanted, especially in getting the grant to have absolute poverty. And literally, it came at the very end of her life. But she had already written her own rule of life. I think she was the first woman to do so in the church. And she embodied a spirit that was uniquely hers. And so St. Clare is a real inspiration for me as a Catholic living today in the church.